you probably have a good idea of what pressure is. It's a song by these guys, sampled in the 90s by this guy, which is now in your head. You're welcome. So here's the question. How do you measure pressure? Well, it takes a 1-2 punch of theory and technology. Let's start with theory. When you divide the force applied to a surface by the area of that surface, you get pressure. To measure force, you need to understand strain. We describe strain as a ratio. It relates the change in the length of a material to its initial length. You see, when an object is subjected to pressure or stress, it changes its shape. The stress is turned to strain. With those two formulas in mind, we can talk about the instruments we use to measure pressure. Pressure transducers are nifty devices that convert pressure into an analog electrical signal. Many pressure transducers use a type of resistor called a strain gauge. Under tension, a strain gauge stretches out, narrows, and increases its resistance. And when compressed, the gauge shortens, broadens, and lowers its resistance. The best way to extract an electrical signal from a strain gauge is to use a wiring configuration called the Wheatstone bridge. Its name sounds like an upscale subdivision, but a Wheatstone bridge is a configuration of 4 equal resistors. When we apply strain, these resistors change linearly by equal magnitude. The bridge creates a voltage output that is proportional to the force it receives. In other words, the greater the pressure on the bridge, the greater its output. Since you can find pressure sensors in a variety of contexts, people have developed different versions of sensors. In extreme temperatures, people use unamplified sensors. These send a fast response with a low voltage signal. Because the unit does not have ICs, it can remain operable in temperature extremes. When people need outputs to travel longer distances, they choose amplified sensors. As you'd expect, amplified signals are less susceptible to environmental noise. Finally, for the lowest noise and longest transmission distances, people choose digital sensors. That's a quick look at how people measure pressure in industrial settings. Every day, people are sensing incredible things. Visit omega.com to learn more.